Oscarine Masuluke.
I like Giroud's goal, but I have to give credit to the goalkeeper. He never go forward and he try amazing goal too.
You've never seen anything like that in your life.
I think it has to be the goalkeeper with the overhead kick. Incredible goal, and the celebration matched it as well.
Not too many strikers or players get to score this kind of goals.
Hello, Africa. SuperSport commentator in Kevin Rocky Evans says you've never seen a goal like that in your life. Whilst one of the two best players of his generation in Cristiano Ronaldo, big ups, Oscarine Masuluke's Tanner. And of course, England international Harry Kane not only loves the goal, but the celebration to boot as well. Let's talk about your football. Let's talk about your footballers in a show, of course, that looked back on the FIFA awards and where Oscarine Masuluke, in fact, did not win the Puskas Award. We'll get into it with, of course, the wise men in Thomas Benite. We'd also like to say hello to Stan Matthews of SuperSport United and congratulate you and your team in reaching the final, of course, of the CAF Confederations Cup, and Jeff Katala as well. Now, in continuing our conversation, of course, about Oscarine Masuluke, here's the thing, if you haven't heard, he has actually not won an award, whether locally or internationally, for that goal. We'll start off with the goal that beat him, of course, in South Africa for the 2015-16 goal of the season. In Sipiwe Shabalala's goal, many of you will remember him, of course, from the 2010 FIFA World Cup. This is out in Cape Town against Cape Town City. He scored this goal, Stanner, top-notch goal, and one of the very best we saw last season. Here's the thing about it, he did it again a week later against SuperSport United in the game I happen to be commentating. Similar goal. Again, I'll implore you to think back to the words of Kevin Rocky Evans. You've never seen a goal like this anywhere in your life. So the goal that beat him in the way of the South African award beat him twice, in fact was scored twice, by the same player in a couple of weeks. Let's move on to the goal that beat him in the way of the international goal for the Puskas Award, of course, from Oliver Giroud. Now, let's firstly look back at a goal scored by Manchester United Mkhitaryan's goal, scorpion kick. This was about a week or so before the goal that eventually beat Oscarine Masuluke to the Puskas Award. And when Giroud did it, the commentator's words were, of course, Giroud, eat your heart out. Anything Giroud can do, or rather Mkhitaryan can do, Giroud can do as well. This was about a week or two later as well. It was fresh in the commentator's mind the week scored before. Now, TK,
yeah.
In this case, the voting for the best goals, for the best players and so on, is it now brought into question when you look at the fact that a goal we've never seen before in our lives didn't win, and goals that beat him on two occasions were scored a week apart twice?
You see, the problem, Sizwe, I think, my take is that players who do not participate in the big three, in the EPL, in the Italian league, the Spanish La Liga, I think they are at a disadvantage because the EPL is broadcast worldwide. And as a result, people in Asia, in Canada, in Brazil, all over, they are able to see that goal and they can vote. Oscarine Masuluke, you know, we hailed his goal. Even the commentator, Kevin Evans, has said, you will never see another goal like that, scored by a goalkeeper for that match. Unfortunately, how many people saw it?
And the whole world saw it. It went viral.
I think it did. It did go viral. But unfortunately, in this instance, it becomes a popularity contest. That is why you look at, in South Africa, Oscarine, many of us felt, you know what? It's a dead giveaway. Oscarine will win it with his eyes closed. But unfortunately, because he plays for what is called an unfashionable side from Limpopo, he has to, contest against a player who plays for a team that has the most support across Southern Africa, not only in South Africa, and it's a no-brainer.
Now, it's a goal, if you haven't seen it, and I'm sure everybody has, worldwide, over and over again, from the very next year after it was scored, that, of course, was scored by a man who plays for a club, Stan, that was just making the entry into the top flight of South African football. He was an unknown before last season, of course, Oscarine Masuluke. You, of course, are with SuperSport United. And maybe we'll understand the difficulties for clubs like Baroka in the popularity concept against Kaizer Chiefs, Orlando Pirates. You've won league titles, you've won Cup titles, yet your support base doesn't match those of, let's say, a Sundowns, a Chiefs, a Pirates, traditionally. If a SuperSport United player had scored that goal, do you think he would have won at least goal of the season in South Africa?
I don't think so, but it's not really important for us. You know, in football, first of all,
it's all about opinions. So whether you are in under six in your amateur club, when it comes prize giving, and I think that's why we've seen a big move in amateur football, in grassroots football, under six, seven, eight, nine, every kid gets a trophy, because awards bring politics and stronger opinions. But inside football, in professional football, these kind of awards don't really mean that much, to be honest. It's ceremonial, it's nice, pat on the back, you can feel good. That's not why anybody's playing for those awards. Nothing can take away from what Oscarine did. And I think that for us as clubs, you know, we take the awards with a pinch of salt, an opportunity, a nice night out with the sponsors, sure, with our colleagues, with people. You've got to take it in context. If it's all about winning an award, then you've got to start looking at what's merit, what's commercial, because sponsors want different things. They want reach, they want participation. So they want to encourage the big clubs, the fans of the big clubs, to be in there. So, you know, for us, when you're competing, you're really measured only by one thing, and that's silverware. And, you know, for us as clubs, we don't get lost too much on whether our player, the emotional part. I've had many, many players over the year and coaches that should have won awards that didn't win awards. But their real reward is the silverware, the bonus check, you know, and the satisfaction of the legacy that you leave. That's more important than one night awards where it's down to opinions and sometimes really just commercial factors.
Now, some interesting words given then by Stan Matthews, of course, in the way of fans. And many will agree these sort of awards are more about the fans and trying to get the interaction with the fans, of course, in looking back at the last year's work, the last season's work. But in this case, for the fans, would it not give these awards more merit if maybe, let's say, players and officials were to vote, Jeff?
Well, I beg to differ with some point that Stan has raised.
Yeah.
But when it comes to Africa, and coming from Africa and from a very small club like Morocco, it should have meant a lot for the for the goalkeeper, for Oscarine, and for his fans, and even the fans all over Africa. But the problem is that we African, we haven't voted a lot. And well, then we will say that it is a connectivity problem in some parts of Africa, but we should have been behind the goalkeeper.
In this case,
because he comes from a very small club,
in this case,
he wouldn't be winning an award.
Quickly, in trying to end this conversation as quickly as possible, but giving it the right sort of attention, the process. Is that maybe not what we should be questioning here, TK? And that, yes, we speak of legacy, a word again used by Stan, and I love that word. But for Oscarine's legacy, a man who might not play Bafana Bafana, who might not go to a World Cup, who might not go to an AFCON, I say might not, we don't know. Mm-hmm. But for his legacy and his time there, if this voting process had been voted by coaches and players, do you think he would have won it?
I guess,
rather than fans of an Arsenal or a Real Madrid, which again, are worldwide.
I hear you, Sizwe, but again, You've got to understand that sometimes even the coaches can use their emotions. You know, they could look at it and say, Baroka, Oscarine, who is he? I mean, Giroud is the man. That kind of thing. So I'm not too sure. But again, I hear your point and I understand. And I do support your point that sometimes players are better able to correctly judge a player they themselves have played against. They've played against him, and in their collective opinion, they feel that, you know what, this is the guy. Throughout the season, he has been outstanding. For me, he's the player.
Yeah, but Cesar, we should have started in South Africa. Well, we shouldn't have, like, when we knew that Oscarine was nominated for the Puskas Award at FIFA level, we should have, you know, not leave the fan base vote for the best goalie in the country. Just plebiscite the goal scored by Oscarine that South Africa has given a credit, has recognized him with that beautiful goal. So it will go to FIFA like that, but not Tshabalala is winning here, and you expect Oscarine to win at FIFA while South Africans haven't voted for him.
And also, just to add on to what Jeff is saying, I think the rules have been like that the fans will have to vote. Now, let us not get too carried away and be too emotional because one of our own didn't win and say the rules maybe should be changed.
I'm not even talking internationally. That's why I mentioned the Tshabalala case.
Yes.
That we have to look at it fairly, even locally, like Jeff says.
Yes.
And in this case, as a man who's with the club in SuperSport United, how difficult and how fickle are fans said to be? Is it true that they are fickle at times?
Well, I think that Oscarine should have won. There's no question. That's my opinion. Not hiding away from that opinion. But it's not important, because the fact that we're talking about it for 10 minutes on a show is exactly why the awards is there, to stimulate conversation, discussion, opinion, a share, argue. And, you know, there can never be a right and a wrong, because that's what happened. For me, he was nominated, an unbelievable achievement. I think if he looks back on his life as a professional footballer, it will be one of his most special times, especially against Orlando Pirates in a big game, in front of a big crowd. I think wonderful for him. But if you say to him, that nomination, or you want to win a trophy, or you want to represent your country, there's other goals for Oscar beyond this. It's the fans and the rest of the emotional drive that's pushing the conversation, not so much players. You know, players really don't take these things so personally.
And he had to take selfies with Ronaldo. I mean,
what an experience. That's a dream come true.
You know? He's rubbing shoulders with the best players in the world.
And Ronaldo said that his goal should have won. That's worth more than the trophy.
Harry Kane also mentioned it. And, well, one has to absolutely value the thoughts given here by our wise men. And